Hello and welcome to another video for Miles Touch Toys, Games, Collectibles. And today we are looking at something that is extremely old and very, very rare. We are looking at the 1952 release by the Saalfield Publishing Company from their series of Tom Corbett Space Cadets publications. Now, Tom Corbett Space Cadet was a TV series that aired from 1950 to 1955, and it was all about the Space Academy and the young cadet Tom Corbett, who was the main character in the television series. I don't quite know how many episodes were produced. I don't think there's any record of how many was actually produced, but I do know it ran from October 1950 through to June 1955. I think there were 15 minute episodes on a weekday and a 30 minute episode on a weekend, so there was an awful lot of episodes produced, and it was a very, very popular television show back in the 1950s. And this particular book we're looking at today is all based on that particular television series, Tom Corbett Space Cadet. And this is the book in front of us. And it says, Tom Corbett Space Cadet, pushouts with rocket ships, ray guns, badges, rings, armbands and stand-ups of cadets, pirates and Space Academy. And there you can see an image of Tom Corbett together with a few of his pals. And they're obviously on a planet somewhere in their space suits. And they've just stepped out of their rocket ship by the looks of things. Okay, that's the front of the book. Let's turn it over to the back. And on the back, you can see some images, which are some of the press outs that you have to press out. So you've got this particular one of the space pirate, the belt buckle here, the cadet badge, and the spaceship. And it tells you how to clip the spaceship together to make it throwable and fly. It says a paper clip on the nose of the ship will hold the two parts together and give good balance for gliding. There we go. Okay, that's the back of the book. I think what we're going to do now, we're going to open it up and we're going to have a look at the contents. Okay, so I've opened the book up and I've just noticed something, that there's perforations on the front here. So the actual figures on the front of the book here of Tom Corbett and his pals, this one and this one, are actually press outs. And again, you can press them out and have them as standalone figures. You can just see the perforations in the front of the board there. As we come, and incidentally, this is a big book. Size-wise, it is 36 centimetres, and each page is 26 centimetres. So it's a very, very big book, which they did make them quite big back in those days. So what have we got here? So we've got the pirate ray gun, and it says fold down along centre of the gun to make the gun. You've got another belt buckle, space pirate belt buckle, space wristwatch. You've got Captain Strong, and you've got fold backs here to make him stand up. And you've got Space Cadet here, and again, you've got fold backs to make him stand up. Okay, it says Tom Corbett Space Cadet, copyright MCML by Rockwall Productions, copyright MCML2 by the Saalfield Publishing Company. So 1952, basically. Okay, let's turn the page over. And the next batch of pullouts we've got, pushouts. They're good quality, and the colours are really, really nice and vibrant. And they obviously pull out and make great scenes for you to put together. So you've got the pirate captain, which is the arm insignia, and the Space Academy itself, and you've got the fold backs here to make it stand up, to create a scene. And you've also got the rocket ship blasting off, and again, you've got fold backs there to stand them up to make the scene. Really, really nice cardboard figures. And well, that's nice, and blank. Obviously, that's the center pages, I would imagine. So there we go. So now we've got a double page here. So, if I just move the camera over a little bit, so we start on the left-hand side. So you can see you've got the space scope there. You've got Commander Arkwright, and again, he's got fold backs to make him stand up. He's got a space pirate arm insignia here, and you've got the Titan landscape. And again, it's got fold backs to stand the image up. And you've got finger ring there, so you can press that out and put that around your finger. It loops into the hole at the end. So there we are. That's that. And again, you can make your own scenes with everything here. Let's move back over to this side, to the right-hand side page. And you've got another finger ring at the top there. And you've got the Cadet ray gun. And again, you have to fold down the center of that press out there to make the gun double-sided. You've got the Cadet badge. It says Space Cadet. You've got Astro. Again, he's got fold-back edges to make him stand up. And you've got the Space Pirates. And again, with fold-back edges to make them stand up. Absolute terrific artwork, and these would all look great in a little display. And we got, that's the back of the pages, so we must have another, yep, so we've got another page here, which is the space compass. Again, it presses out. Manning, and again there you've got fold backs to make him stand up. The arm insignia again, and you've got another finger ring down the side here, and you've got the belt communicator just here, and then you've got the image of Tom Corbett and Dr. Joan Dale, and again, fold backs to make them stand up. Okay, and then let's move on to the next page. Wow, look at that. So you've got another finger ring at the top there. And the pirate badge at the top, Space Pirates, and another finger ring on the right-hand side. You've then got the spaceship, and it says fold here. It says spaceship instructions on back cover. Okay, and fold down along the centre of the ship. I think we did look at the instructions for this. Anyway, walkie-talkie two-way space phone, and there's two of those. And you've got Space Captain's arm insignia. And you've got the long range planet scope there. And then I think that, yeah, so then we're back onto the back page, and that's the other half of the rocket ship. So the two parts of the ship go to actually together, for they fold together to create the little ship you can see at the very top there. Okay, and as we looked at this before, because it's a back page, but I've such good quality card has been used in this book. And the artwork is amazing, and all of them press out, even these front ones, which I didn't realise at the time. But they also press out, those two figures, Tom Corbett in his spacesuit and one of his pals in his spacesuit, actually press out as well. So you can make a whole diorama display by pressing out these figures and create your own stories. Absolutely tremendous stuff from the 1950s, 1952. To be precise. So we're talking 72 years old, this book, which is astonishing. And the fact that it's untouched and in incredibly good condition is absolutely amazing. Again, we were fortunate to buy out the stock. I think I've told you this a few times, but we bought out stock from a toy and comic shop that had been around for well over 50 years. They were quite senior, the people that were running the shop, and they had to close during COVID, and they didn't recover afterwards. And we had the opportunity to buy all their stock, which we did do. But the most interesting stuff for me was the stock that we bought from their stockroom, which was all stuff that they hadn't sold over the years. And all these items were put into a boxes or put onto the shelves in the stockroom and left there, and they didn't move. They weren't that computer literate, to be perfectly honest with you, so they weren't interested in trying to sell the items online, and they were very busy with their shop, and they had different ethics to what we have these days, where if it doesn't sell in the shop, you put it online, whereas with them, it was, if it doesn't sell, we just throw it in the back stockroom. So a little bit different ethics to what we know and work with these days. But we were fortunate to buy out all of that stock, and there was so much interesting stuff in the back that went back years and years and years, and this was one of those items that we found in the stockroom. So how well did this do back in the day, back in the 1950s? Well, I'm guessing that it done quite well, because Tom Corbett was a very, very popular television series for kids back in the 1950s. So it's 1950 to 1955 it ran for. So it's five consistent years. But I'd say I don't know how many episodes were produced. I can't seem to find that information, but I'm guessing there was a lot of episodes produced. So any merchandise that was produced for that television series would have sold very well, I would imagine. But things like this, unfortunately, I mean, they're press out stuff. They're not made to last. Even though the quality of these is far, far better than what you would expect. But it's very, very good quality. Very good quality card. And the artwork on them is fantastic. And obviously, you press them out, you make your own diorama. I'm sure the kids of the 50s would have been playing with these, because you didn't get action figures for these kind of things back in the 1950s. That was all, that didn't come about really until the 1960s when the action figures first came out. So this was your action figures back in 1952. So you press these out and you play with these. So and the biggest they're cardboard, I'm sure they would have got damaged. Bent and creased and eventually thrown away, because obviously they weren't made to last. They were made just to really be quick playthings and thrown away, and then you go and buy another one. So that was the whole of the marketing. So yes, they done very well. Of course, now 72 years on, trying to find these particular books in this fantastic condition, well, trying to find one full stop is going to be very, very difficult. Trying to find one like this in this fantastic condition is going to be an almost impossibility. Do they come up on the platforms? I think I have seen one or two on the platforms over the years. I think more so in the States than in the UK. And that's probably because the TV show was obviously made in the US, and it was far more popular in the US than it was in the UK. So I have seen one or two on the platforms over the years, over the last 10, 20 years, I'd imagine. But they really don't come up that often. And when they do, they're usually very, very expensive. And they've usually also, when you find them, you find that they've, some of the models have been pressed out, or they've been pressed out and put back into the book. So you need to be just a little bit vigilant when you are buying on the platforms. So they do pop up from time to time, but not very often, and they are very expensive. However, alternatively, we at Midas Touch have also managed to find one. And you can see this is the one that we have. We only have the one. And you can see the condition of it. It is in absolutely fantastic condition. And all our products are completely photographs shown on every single item. And also the full description of the quality of the item is also printed on the website. And you can get to the website very simply by clicking the link below. It will take you straight to the website where you'll be able to find this item and many, many other vintage space items. And many other vintage toys, games and collectibles come to that. There's over 10,000 products currently available on the website for you to view and purchase at your leisure. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button, because we're uploading videos for every new item that goes into the website. There will be something for everybody, and I am absolutely positive that this is something you won't want to miss, because we literally have thousands and thousands of new products which we're shooting videos for and uploading on a daily basis. So if there's something in particular you're looking for, something old that you've never been able to find, something quirky that you might want to buy for a friend, or maybe just something from your childhood that you'd like to own again to help you recuperate those long-lost childhood memories, well, stay tuned, keep watching, because you never know, the next item we upload could be that item you've been looking for. Okay, that is it for me on this particular item. I do hope you've enjoyed this very short video. Thank you for watching. and we will see you again next time.